A lot going on here in Section 5. We're either going to visit some memories or revisit some memories, depending on whether you've seen this material before or not. We're also going to not just talk about the boot up process for Cisco Switch, but we're going to see it in action. And after all of that, which is a lot, we're going to start securing our Switch. And I know it says switches on the board, but what I've done for this section is taken one of our lab switches and I have erased it to the point where the switch barely knows it's even a switch. I mean, it is erased. I've erased all the config files, gotten rid of all the VLANs, everything I possibly could, and then done a reload. Because that's something, obviously, and hopefully, you're not doing very often at work. And it's a good thing to do in the lab once in a while. Just do a write erase, see the process, you see some things and some tests mentioned that you wouldn't see otherwise, because again, it's not something we do on an everyday basis. Now, just one quick note here, the memory sections and the functions and the contents I'm about to discuss, they're the same in switches and routers. But to avoid saying switches and routers, probably not 300 times, but at least a couple of times, I'll just say switches if I can. We'll see if I can make it. Of the following, especially the last two we discussed, take note of which ones lose their contents on a reload and which ones do not. That's good stuff to know. Now, first off, we start off with ROM, the one everybody's heard about, read-only memory. ROM stores the switch's bootstrap startup program, the operating system software, and the power-on diagnostic test program, POS. And you're probably looking at that and saying, I don't think POST is an acronym for power-on diagnostic test programs. Well, that's actually what they are, but the acronym POST stands for power-on self-test, and we'll talk more about that on the very next screen. Now, flash memory is almost always just called flash. And this is where the Cisco IOS images are stored. If you have enough flash, you may have more than one image stored there, but most devices just have the one they're going to use. Flash is erasable, reprogrammable ROM, and thankfully for us, flash content is also retained on a reload because you wouldn't want to load a new iOS image into flash every single time you reloaded a device. And of course, the iOS image is what makes a Cisco switch a Cisco switch, so we got to have that. Here are the two you got to watch, RAM and NVRAM. With random access memory, some important stuff there, obviously. We've got routing and switching tables are going to be kept there. The routing tables that we're going to build a couple of sections from now, the switching tables, the MAC address tables that we've already seen, and the running configuration file. Now, RAM contents are lost when the router is powered down or reloaded, as compared to non-volatile RAM. And NVRAM holds the router's startup configuration file. And NVRAM contents are not lost on a reload. A quick note here about the startup and running config files, because I'm going to go into that in another section, but I also know that you are asking, what's the difference? You know, why do I have two config files? Here's the way I always remembered it when I started studying. The running config file is the latest overall version of the config file. It's the one with the latest changes that you've made. The startup config file is the latest saved version of your config file. So if you've made changes and saved them, the contents of your startup config file and your running config file will be the same. If you have made changes and not saved them, the running config file and the startup config file will have different contents. Now, they're different files anyway, but sometimes they're going to be exactly the same and sometimes they're not. Quick note here, if you try to reload and you've made changes, but you have not yet saved them, then what's going to happen is the switch will prompt you, you know, hey, you've made changes since your last save. Do you want to save these changes? Enough on that. Now, let's talk about the boot process here and go back to those posts for a few minutes. Now, when a switch powers up, it's going to run a series of power-on self-tests. And this is the switch running a couple of fundamental tests, fundamental diagnostics, and really saying, I'm going to test these things before I even really start booting up, because if these things ain't working, ain't nothing working. And obviously, it doesn't quite say that on the screen, but that's what happens. It's going to test some things to do with the interfaces, the memory, the CPU. Power-on self-tests will vary from one device, one model to another, but fundamentally, we're checking the same things. Because let's say if the fan isn't working, then the switch is going to look at that and say, hey, there's no use in me even booting because you can't use me. Now, here are some of the post results I saw when reloading our freshly erased switch, and now you can see them as well. Now, these would have been performed whether I erased the file or not. And you can see some tests there that mention the CPU. You can see some tests that mention CAM subsystems, some port loopback tests. And you don't necessarily see every post a device runs here on the screen as it boots. You see most of them, but you may not see every single one. The key here is we see begin and end status passed on every single one, and we will take that every single time we can get it. So we were in good shape there. Now, if we had been in bad shape, if the post had detected some kind of problem that caused the router to overheat after booting, like that broken fan, then the following things are going to happen. First off, a post is going to fail. Second, the device will tell you exactly what post failed. Third, the boot process will stop. And fourth, your stomach will begin to hurt. And your body part may vary. I like to go with stomach myself. I've really only had that happen, I think, twice out of the thousands and thousands of devices that I've handled from Cisco. And, you know, someone else's mileage may vary. But I just remember that one time we were swapping it out at a client, started up this hardware, and I was really proud of myself. And we had the spare hardware sitting around. We're going to bring the client back to life. And the fan was broken. And I can chuckle now, but that message just came up. Environmental variable failed. Some phrases you never forget. And I still remember that one. But fortunately for us in our switch and in our walkthrough here, the posts are all passes. Then the switch needs an iOS image. And there are actually three places from which it can load an iOS image, and it looks for them in this order. Flash, which we mentioned earlier, that is the default location. Secondly, it could look for what we call a TFTP server, a Trivial File Transfer Protocol server, which can just be another device in your network. You know, a Cisco router can serve as a TFTP server. Finally, it will look in ROM for kind of a limited iOS. Now, I want to talk about that for a moment, actually. I want to say back to the boot. Let me go back to the screen, because I know the first question a lot of you are going to have when you see this, can I change the order? And I'm getting way ahead here, but I'm going to answer this question because I know you have it. Yes, you can. And no, I'm not going to show you how to do it. Not yet. Well, what you end up doing is configuring what we call the config register on the device. And if the word register sounds like registry, which might sound like Microsoft registry, which sounds like something you should edit only if you know exactly what's going to happen as a result, you're right, because you have to be really careful. You can actually just make the device useless if you make the wrong edit with the config register. So more about that later in your studies, I promise, but I did want to answer that question. Yes, you can change that order. Once that iOS image is found, all we need is a valid startup config file. And the order of that search, first, switch is going to look in NVRAM. Next, going to look in TFTP server, whether it's a router or a switch. This is the order. And third, you're prompted with system configuration dialog. What the heck is that? You're going to see exactly what it is coming up next.